Again and say like what did you say before? What do you think of Google? I think that's what you
What do you
said.
think about Google?
Impressive achievement. Still, I got everything I know from Bing.
Yeah.
Hello and welcome to the Gamer SEO podcast number 32. I really just wanted to start off the podcast with that. So, if you ask Cortana on Windows 10
So
about Google,
sassy.
she'll say impressive achievement, but I still get everything I want from Bing. That's amazing. She really
Bing.
does it. I'm one of your hosts, TBCX, but you can call me Teddy. And I have with me, as I do every week, the man of the week every week.
Legend PVM, also known as Eric.
I just stopped that time. Usually, what are you doing?
I
You're like, man, your camera's like going ham too. I usually like say your name and then let you like finish it, but that time I just stopped. I'm like, I'm just gonna let him do
My
everything.
fan just fell down.
I saw that. Man.
Oh, by the way, my fan is broken.
Oh, that's messed up, dude.
Sad.
Did you? So wait, where does that sit?
On top of my computer.
The fuck?
It
So you
used to
have
be
a
on top of my there, but there was no more space down here
but
for all more cords,
is
so.
it just like constantly pointed at you?
No, I move it away sometimes if it gets too intense, but.
Okay, all right.
Well, now it doesn't work, so.
Rip in
Rip.
peace, fan.
Yeah.
We are an entertainment podcast that mostly talks about video games,
And fans.
PlayStation, Destiny. Also, every week we have a very long hour. We have an hour podcast, which is normal, and then we also have a bonus hour-long podcast just about fans. It's very,
Yes,
very
yes.
awesome.
About our fans,
And what we
our
think.
dear
My
fans.
fan is broken. My ceiling fan? I think I've
Oh
told
my
you this
gosh,
before.
yeah.
My ceiling. People who don't know, we're moving my mattress downstairs, and as you can see if you're watching the video version, I have a loft. So we had to like grab it out of the and it my dad just freaking hit the ceiling
Ham on
fan
the ceiling
blade
fan.
with the mattress and it just bent. So it's not completely broken, like it still works, but when it goes around it's like a rattling. But it works. If it's super hot in here, I still turn it on and like deal with
I
it.
mean,
I
you
got a
could
headset.
just take off the blade.
Yeah, but then it's like all lopsided and whatnot. It's really not that bad. Like it still works really well. It just there's a tiny little like sound,
Yeah.
and if I have my headset on, I don't hear it at all. So what have you been playing this
What I've been
weekend?
playing? Oh man, I have been playing
You know what? Freaking.
a lot of Destiny.
I'm gonna freaking open my PlayStation, look at my recently played, because I don't even know.
I played a little Rocket League.
Yeah, Rocket League. Rocket League.
Outside of that, honestly. Well, I mean, Halo. Lots of Halo
Dude,
2. Oh, yeah.
that one night where we just went ham on Halo, I
We
think
got
was last week. I think it
it.
was like last Tuesday or something. Where was one night where me and Eric started Halo 2 and got through 10 out of 15 missions in one
Yep.
night? And now we're on 12 out of
We got
15, so
like
we
three
have three more,
more.
yeah.
We need to do that sometime.
Oh, Gabby's on Destiny right now. Sorry.
Uh-oh.
I just opened my PlayStation. I'm gonna look at my recently played games for that. So,
Yeah.
Halo, Destiny, like always, Rocket League. Any PC things? Got that
I
Windows 10
tr I tr yeah, I
Minecraft
tried that.
It's
Very
something.
limited.
Yeah.
It does have more stuff than the PC version though, the Java PC.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
It's very. You said you had a bad experience with it
Well, I
optimization
mean,
wise.
I opened it again later, I think there was an update and it fixed
Oh.
it. Everything
Yeah,
was fine.
dude. But like in the state that it is now. It's really like quick. Like
It's
I
more optimized than the Java version, definitely.
yeah, I opened the freaking new world and had one in about like 5, 10 seconds. It's
The only
crazy.
problem, the main problem with it is that the menus are horrible. But I mean, there needs to be like an option to switch between like a PC, or if you play on a console or a touchpad, you know?
Yeah, menus aren't that great. And I don't know. The one thing that I took away from that was that the menu, the sliders, like, instead of for mouse sensitivity on the regular Java one, it's like 100-something% when you do the slider. But on this one, it's just a slider. So, like, you just have to mess around with it until you think you have what you might have. But it's like, normally, it's just like, oh, I'm going to go to 125 or whatever mine is.
Right.
But that's, like, my one gripe with that. Otherwise, I don't fully get what they're doing there.
Yeah.
Maybe there's something that I'm missing, but
I think they're just trying to make it accessible all over Windows 10 devices and Xbox One.
Yeah, because you know when you, I guess so. Because when you open the thing, like it didn't know that I had Minecraft, but it was there on the start menu, you know.
Right.
So like, if somebody who doesn't have Minecraft is like, oh, it's right here, I'll just buy it for $10 in the Windows Store. Yeah. All right, that's cool. That's cool. If that's all you've been playing for the past week.
And Destiny, obviously. Lots of Destiny. And you'll probably know why tonight. But, it's been fun. Lots of Iron Banner, Iron Banana, and the Charles of Stars. The Salty Spittoon.
Oh, man. Yeah. So, I have been playing many things, but at the same time, many things. At the same time, not that many things, though, because I was off last week, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, 3 days in a row off of work, and it was freaking glorious, but it was obviously never going to happen again. So I played a lot of games, like, I don't know if this was Monday or Tuesday. One of the days, I was like, I couldn't figure out what I was in the mood to play. So I sat down and finished the Call of Duty Advanced Warfare single player campaign. And then I was like, this is really fun. And I got trophies for like 8 hours. So here, look at, I'm going to show them with my webcam. Look at what my recent recent activities looks like. It's just like you're scrolling down, it's like play Destiny, play this, play that, and then scroll down, and it's just like earn trophy, advanced warfare. Like I have like 70% of the trophies now.
Wow.
But I had a lot of fun doing that. But then one of the other days, me and Ryan and Eric sat down, we beat Skolas in Destiny. That was
good. We all got the Elder Cipher.
Yes!
Yes!
One of three. Just tossing that out there. And then we basically... What else? We did Skolas that one day. Me and Eric played Halo one night. I don't know what night that was. I have no idea.
I don't remember either.
We played Minecraft like last Sunday after we did the podcast. So that was a thing. And then Destiny, I sat down and did bounties one day. That's pretty much it. Oh, wait, no. Two nights ago, I think it was Friday. Yeah, Friday. On days that I work, I don't normally play games. Well, I don't know. I used to, but last week I didn't. I didn't play any games with like any people, like any multiplayer games. I just like sat down because I would get home and I would have to do crap, and then I only like Friday and Saturday I had an hour to play games. I sat down and had to go to sleep at like 9:30, and I sat down and finished crap I had to do at 8:30. I was like, all right, what can I do here? And so you probably know this, but I've had The Walking Dead Season 1 on my PS4 because it was on sale, and I bought it, and I was like, if there ever is a Season 3, I want my saves on PS4. So I'm like, I don't mind replaying that game for the sixth time. It's fine. So I started that again on Friday, and I played for like an hour on Friday and an hour on Saturday. And like, I made it to the pharmacy, and that's where I am. So it's like, it's...
Wow.
Yeah. An hour a night. Actually, one night was like 45 minutes, actually, but...
There was a PC game that I did play that's reminded me. Freaking Game of Thrones...
Oh, yeah.
Episode 5 came out.
Yeah.
And I have... Got some of those. The ending, I'm just gonna say, freaking... My poor heart, my poor dear heart. I was seriously upset. I slammed my hands and like got up from my desk and was like, no! I screamed.
Telltale's so good at that, dude.
Like, it was like one of those choices like in Walking Dead episode 1 or 2 where you're choosing between Doug and the chick.
Yeah.
That it was kind of like that, only you've been with them for like 4 episodes. And it's just like the worst thing ever.
That's crazy.
So,
but see, if someone from Telltale was watching this podcast right now, they would literally be watching and listening and being like, yes, yes, we did it, boys. We're having a pizza party tonight. Pizza stream.
Yeah, it was.
They're messed up people.
It was heart wrenching. And, like, yeah. So.
They're messed up people.
It was good, though. It was good. It got me. It got me good.
And that there, Telltale. But, yeah so I don't know. Dude, the last time I did it, I was on PS3. I was on PS4, actually. I was playing it through on PS3 through PlayStation Now for the free trophies. And I was like, yeah. I have a 7-day trial of this. I'm going to freaking play through this. But the PS4 has a separate trophy list, so I'm going to get another platinum.
What?
For The Walking Dead.
That's so dumb.
I'm so excited. I think
that's so dumb.
But I think the Vita and the PS3 share trophy list.
Yeah.
The Vita, what if the Vita had a different trophy list? And then I'll play through it for the 7th time. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do that.
That would be cheap. I would not do that.
Yeah. Well, I'm not actually doing easy. This last time I did it for the trophies. This time, and it was free. This time I legitimately am doing it because, like, if they have a season 3, I want to play it on.
Choices, mate.
Yeah, because this is like my save. Like, this is going to be, if they do a season 3, I will play it on PS4. So it's like, I got to do.
Mate, you still got your.
I don't even know if playthrough. I don't even. Oh, yeah. Oh, I don't even know if I have my PC saves, though. Like, been so long, I've transferred hard drives, I don't know.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, no,
it
would still be on Steam Cloud, so it's...
I don't know if it is. I disabled that at some point because there was a Torchlight 2 bug, and yeah. So I freaking have no idea. That was the best face, by the way. That's amazing.
You should go find that afterwards and have it as a thumbnail.
Just blown up to really big.
It's like the right here on my face.
But so it's like, but when I was playing through it on PlayStation Now, I was like watching videos and whatnot and just sort of like not listening. But now, since it's like this is my save, I'm paying attention because I want the right choices. And like, I don't know.
Are you gonna cut off his arm?
But, oh yeah. Oh yeah. Every time. Yeah. But I cut off his gosh dang arm 5 times. But the, pretty much. But, like, this time, I don't know why. Maybe it's just because PS Now was it didn't look good. It was frame rate problems because of because it was running off of the PS3 version. And then there was a tiny bit of latency. So it's like, all of that mixed together made it not look that great. And then, now that I'm playing it natively on my PS4, I'm like, this actually looks really good and plays well. Yeah. I'm like paying attention and like sitting here alone, like in the dark, just playing for like I did the first time. So I'm enjoying it, surprisingly. I've kind of already gotten to the point where I'm like, man, I've played this so many. I know exactly what happens next. Why am I? But I'm kind of enjoying it, so it's good. I bought season 2, so that's a thing. Before we move on to the news, that's mostly what I've been playing. But before we move on to the news, I want to show you people what I did last week because I think it's cool. I made a Google document. Let me switch over to this. I made a Google document of the upcoming games and the ones that I'm interested in. And the anonymous raccoon is here. You're a raccoon, by the way. Oh. Which is a pretty dope animal to be. But you're freaking Sly Cooper up in here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But I made the list, and it's very detailed. Everything is sorted by date. This is basically to help me keep track of gosh dang games, because there's so many of them. I have a section that is like definite pre-orders, and then definite pre-orders that can't be ordered at the moment.
Cool. Hold on a second. Is that Uncharted 4 date like?
No, that's a placeholder.
Okay.
That's the last day of. But see, that's the placeholder for spring, for the spring quarter for Q1 of 2016.
Okay.
But the first. Yeah, and that's the last day considered of Q1 though, so it's gonna be before that, most likely. Yeah,
I'm gonna guess like 11th.
Sure, yellow. But yeah, so I have definite pre-orders that can't be ordered at the moment. Games that I need to keep an eye on and maybe get just like to, you know, freaking so that I don't forget them. so and then I have all games on this list and they're ordered by date and I have giant pre-ordered in bold and all caps next to them. So when I actually officially pre-order them, it's like that's off the list. I don't have to worry about that one. So this week I pre-ordered the Dishonored Definitive Edition, which actually comes out August 25th, which I thought was funny. Yeah, I was like, all right,
you're gonna have a new game already about this. It's starting already.
Yeah, it's kicking off the fall. And then Destiny the Taken King is that's more kind of kicking off the fall because that's where
is that
what
next,
everyone's gonna be
is
talking
that
about.
Next month.
Yep, 9/15.
Pretty
so
sure
I pre-ordered
like 40 some days.
Yeah. I think it was like 45 yesterday.
Yeah, 45, yeah. Saw something about that.
Yeah. Dude, every time I see more stuff about Taken King, I get more and more excited.
Yeah.
Uncharted the Nathan Drake Collection, pre-ordered. These are the first four, and I have the first four pre-ordered, so there we go. Halo 5 Guardians, I pre-ordered that one. And the one that I pre-ordered also with my most recent paycheck, which I was looking at this, I was like, after I made this doc, I was like, why did I do that? What the heck? I also pre-ordered Ratchet and Clank, which is the most far out game. That's the weird thing. I'm not bummed that I pre-ordered
almost
that.
Almost a year from
yeah,
now.
I'm not bummed that I pre-ordered it. I'm definitely going to play it. It looks awesome. But like, it's freaking so next, fun. Like, June.
Right.
I'm like, why did I do that? But yeah, it's the last one on the list. But yeah, after Halo 5 Guardians, these are the ones that I haven't pre-ordered. I gotta get on next paycheck, Black Ops 3, Fallout 4, Star Wars Battlefront, The Division. The Division is able to be pre-ordered right now, by the way.
Oh.
Yeah, that's why these are definite pre-orders. You would think that would be under the list that's like, you know, pre-orders that can't be ordered, but it isn't.
I'm gonna need more space.
Yeah, okay. Physical games.
I mean, I'm not complaining. I got these cool cases here.
Then you for the pre-orders that can't be ordered, you got No Man's Sky, which is supposed to come out this year, but they haven't freaking said anything about the release date.
So weird that they haven't said anything.
Yeah, I feel like it's coming close. I feel like either not games, maybe Gamescom.
Gamescom, yeah.
But not really because it's like a Sony first party and Sony's not going to be there. I don't know. But it's, well, they might be third party. I don't know. But yeah, maybe Gamescom. If not, Paris Games Week. But that might be really far away. I don't know when that is. December 2015, Battleborn. I think that's cool that that's December. Not too many games are December. I like that. Yeah. Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands. I really want that game, but they haven't. That was apparently shown off pretty early. Like, that's ways off, so I just wrote that there to keep an eye on it. And then Doom in the spring of next year. Freaking the ones that I need to keep an eye on, Everybody's Gone to the Rapture, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, and Mirror's Edge Catalyst. Those are the ones. So yeah, I was mainly going over those so like people who watch this podcast have similar gaming interests to us. So
yeah.
Keep an eye on this. I also tweeted this out. If you want a link to this, go to my Twitter. It's all here. Freaking next paycheck. Yeah. I am hopefully gonna. Oh man. I don't know. I can't wait until all these have the pre-ordered check next to them. Cause freaking Black Ops 3, Fallout 4. Also, Black Ops 3, Fallout 4, and Battlefront and Halo 5 Guardians are all coming out within like a month of each other.
Rip.
They,
dude,
like,
Fallout 4 apparently has like more than 200 hours of gameplay. So
more than,
I mean,
400.
Yeah, 400. That's sorry.
400.
But like,
that's what we're gonna talk about later, mate. But yeah. Freaking, we're gonna talk about it right now. One of the producers was, or one of the game devs was saying that he has been testing the game and playing it for 400 hours and still finds new stuff.
Wow.
So, and remember when that was a headline for The Witcher, but it was 200 hours, and now it's like Now we're gonna double that.
Right.
Gosh dang it. Why is everyone making these huge games? I can't beat them all. I don't have the time.
See, I think that Fallout 4 will be more manageable, though, because I feel like a lot of stuff in The Witcher was, like, kind of mandatory. You're probably going to have to put up 200 hours into the game to do every...
Yeah.
Mostly everything.
You're saying Fallout 4, the main story,
there's a lot of extra
probably be...
options.
You're saying
content.
The main story will probably be shorter?
Oh, yeah. The main story will definitely be, I'm going to guess... 40-50 hours.
That would be awesome. I'd be down for that. That's good.
And of course there's gonna be side quests everywhere, so I mean.
Yeah. But yeah, this is a cool list. I keep, the more I think about this crap, the more excited I get. Freaking Taken King has new crucible modes. That's gonna change how we play the game. There's a new raid. That's just one of the games coming out. Just one of them. Then Uncharted. I get to play all three freaking games again. It's so exciting. Hey, you get Uncharted 4 beta access. Halo 5 Guardians. I just finished Hunt the Truth last week, people listening. Which was freaking awesome.
I wanted to talk about that. I put that in the...
All right, I guess we'll talk about it a little bit.
I wanted to say, since we were talking about pre-order stuff, which one should I pre-order? Because I want to get those exclusive items, but I'm not...
I have no idea what you're talking about. You get the exclusive items everywhere you pre-order it.
Yes, I understand.
As long as you pre-order
the game. Talking about
the...
there was, like, the digital collector's edition that gets, like, an exotic... exotic class item, exotic sparrow, or something like that. And I was like, huh?
All of that stuff will be available... The whole... Do you not remember the drama, mate? That everyone was like, why can't I buy this stuff without having to rebuy the game? All of that stuff is available to buy when the Taken King launches separately, so that we don't have to... For $20. So that we don't have to buy it for $80. We can buy it for $60 instead, and not buy House of Wolves and Dark Below again.
Alright, so basically I need $6, or $60 for...
Yeah, but... What sucks is that you can't, like, pre-order that yet. It's going to be available when the Taken King launches, so just have $20.
So I should just go on...
Just buy a $20 PSN card and keep it in your drawer for when...
Yeah, that.
For when Destiny launches.
But, I mean, like, for now, I should probably just pre-order the Taken King version, $40 regular.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I did.
All right.
Halo 5 Guardians, the story is going to be awesome. And the multiplayer, 12v12, freaking,
it's gonna be great.
And then you got Black Ops 3, which is like, to be honest, I think what was funny is that everyone used to view Infinity Ward as the best, like, Call of Duty developer. I think Treyarch is, like, undoubtedly the best at the moment.
I think they're, when they make a game, they have a different kind of feel about them.
Yeah, it feels different.
It's very obvious and
fresh.
Yeah,
I like it. And freaking, just from, like, the past... Black Ops 1, everyone loved. And from what I've heard, everyone really liked Black Ops 2. Like, Black Ops 2 was apparently really good.
I was good at it, and I enjoyed it. I enjoyed Nuketown 2.0 in the bad sniping spots in the garages.
And then and then Ghost came out, and everyone hated Ghost, and that was Infinity Ward. And then Advanced Warfare came out, and by and large, the community was not a big fan of Advanced Warfare. So now it's like Treyarch is coming, like, they could follow the trend and have a horrible one, but, like, from the track record, it's like, this one is going to, I don't know, it's gonna be good. Like, Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 are both good. Like, if they followed the Modern Warfare trend, Modern Warfare 3 was good, was really good. So, like, if Black Ops 3 is anywhere near, then, that's gonna be real good. Freaking zombies. Fallout 4, oh my gosh. Star Wars, that's all I can say about that. Star Wars Battlefront has... The more I hear about that, the more excited I get.
Yeah. I mean, I am really excited about it, but, like, I've been trying to, like, stay away from, like, gameplay for some reason, because I know it's not going to be, like, freaking Destiny where you have all these freaking missions and raids to do. But it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun to play. But I know it's not... You could probably see what there is to have in the gameplay, which is
I'm excited. That's why I'm keep watching it. Yeah, freaking the survival mode, like they're like a two-player like and there's like co-op missions. Yeah. Like I the more I hear about stuff, like I'll see an article post on Facebook from IGN that's like, we talked with one of the and it's basically just being like them going over the co-op mission stuff for like a minute, and it's like, the more I hear stuff like that, the more I realize that it's real and it's happening like this fall. Like it's, I kept, when I sold my PS2 and all of my games, I kept Battlefront 2 because that was my favorite game. It's over there and I don't have a system to play it on, but my disc is over there just because. Freaking The Division is gonna be awesome. Uncharted 4 is next year. There's so much stuff.
You see this right here?
Yeah. You kept it too.
Yes, on the Xbox.
Like, yeah, see, yours isn't even in the legit case. Mine isn't either.
Yeah.
Mine's
it's
just in...
a bunch of, it's paper.
Oh my gosh.
It's lined paper stapled together.
Mine's not that bad. Here, I'll freaking get mine. Hold on.
I won't be able to see it, but... I just keep it down here next to my, thing.
I know. What is that?
I keep it next to my, my graduation thing. I can't think of.
Alright, well, here's mine. Random, showing off our Battlefronts.
You can't even see it.
Yeah, I know, poor Eric. Battlefront 2, PlayStation 2, it's just in a black freaking, I don't even know. I'm so excited for Battlefront.
Yeah, man.
What else? You know what other game that I'm excited about?
Video games.
Well, yeah, in general. But specifically?
The Division.
Close, but not really. Halo 5. And you know what Halo 5 isn't getting in the fall, dude?
What?
Split screen.
Yep.
You know what's weird about this article?
It's kind of big.
What's weird about this article is that I thought this was confirmed like 2 months ago. And now everyone's like, well, it's not getting... I'm like... What?
It was confirmed quite a while ago. I even expected it because of the Warzone thing, especially.
I don't know.
And they're wanting to keep the 60 FPS because they want to make it a competitive shooter, and most competitive shooters are 60 FPS. So, I mean.
To be honest, I also think that they're putting it as at 60 FPS because I think that this is, you know, this is their first game on the new current gen consoles. It's like, I think they're trying to push the industry forward when it comes to the frames. Like, that's what it's going to do, hopefully.
Halo is, like, the leading game for the Xbox, and it's got to be pretty for it's what it is.
Halo is, like, the face of Xbox. Like, if somebody comes over and's like, hey, here, if your friend comes over and you're like, hey, I want to show them what my Xbox can do, like, let's show them the power of the Xbox. Boot up. Freaking Halo 5.
Xbox
show
is offline.
Show it 60 FPS. Lizard Squad's at it again. Oh no. Yeah, so everyone's upset about that, but me and Eric, I think, understand it more than most people. I can understand why you're upset.
I completely understand because Halo is a very, very split screen heavy.
Like a lot of people played it.
A lot of people would just come over and just have fun. That's what Halo was all about back in the day, but I mean.
Like, a lot of people played...
Comes to...
Like, my brother-in-law played Halo 2, 3, and 4 all co-op.
Yeah.
So, I understand.
But I understand, but I don't think it's worth it, honestly. Yeah. I don't think it's worth it. You can still play if you really want to play Halo, you'll get an Xbox, so you can play with your friends, you know?
Yeah.
Get a job!
Just get a job! It's that easy, Andrew! Sorry.
Timestamp. Copy paste.
Opening old wounds there. Oh, so I may have while you were talking, I may have just realized that your border is like completely messed up. It was like pushed over like out of the red border, like your screen.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to also...
Where's my face then? Was I like cut off or something?
No, it was just, like, over to the right a little bit.
Oh, so...
Okay, I think... Okay, we're good. We're good. We're moving on. So let's put through this news quickly. We spent a lot of time talking about the upcoming games. Gamescom is upcoming, is coming up in this week.
August 5th through 9th?
Yeah, that's happening.
It's going to be good. It's going to be good.
So, just letting you guys know, like we did with Comic-Con, and then we didn't do a show that week. we'll talk about Gamescom next week. That's
Yeah, I think we should just, like, literally have a short, like, 30-minute thing, I don't know, on it, like, during the week or something. I'm down for that. I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know. I like the, well, let's see. 5th through 9th is... Yeah, 9th is Sunday, so...
Okay.
The 9th is Sunday.
Guess that works out, then.
Yeah, it'll probably end that day, and we'll be able to...
I mean, what if someone comes out and be like, Half-Life 3?
Then follow us on Twitter, at TVCAC and at LegendPVM.
Yeah. or live updates on Gamescom.
That's what I did with E3, to be totally honest. Yeah. I kind of went a little ham, unnecessarily. So what on here tickles your fancy? What here tickles your peach?
I kind of want to group them together. Since we've been talking a lot about Halo, let's talk about Hunt the Truth for a minute.
Okay.
Let's talk about... how good the voice acting and the sound design is. It isn't just incredible for just an audio series. I guess that's what you would call it.
But, don't spoil it, but I just want to say that ending, though. That's it. Oh, it's so and good.
It's, if you have not seen Hunt the Truth, it is something, like, if you play a game that you can just, like, listen to something, like music or... you know, Destiny. Audiobooks or something. Like Destiny, especially.
If you listen to this podcast, you're most likely a Destiny player.
Sure.
So while you're doing bounties, just...
Yeah, if you're doing bounties or if you're on Witcher, just grinding some stuff or...
I don't know how their Witchers work. They're just killing
I've forgotten how... I know there's a lot of grinding
in gobbles.
But yeah, if you're doing something that's not so... focus intensive. You can just listen to Hunt the Truth, and it's so worth it because it gets intense. Because I was actually playing Destiny, trying to just listen to Hunt the Truth, and then I was like playing. Then I was like, what? And then I just kind of just stared at my computer, just like listening to it. And then I look over to my left afterward. It's like, oh, you've gone to orbit.
I was driving home, and it was like a 30-minute drive. And I had like 10 minutes left, and I stopped when I pulled into my driveway and just sat there. And continued.
You just sat there and was like...
I just continued. Yeah, I'm like, I gotta hear the end of this. This is amazing. So, yeah, for real. It's basically an audiobook / podcast / TV show.
Yeah.
It's awesome. It's really cool.
And, the best thing about it, it's like, it's more than an audiobook because there's audio. Like, you can hear movements and... breathing and they act out what's going on.
Yeah,
like it's acted out but in sound, and it's cool to like imagine like the situations and the scenes.
Even if you're not getting Halo 5 or if you're a PlayStation people like I am,
oh yeah, definitely
listen to that.
It's yeah, like really cool. You could be completely oblivious of the Halo universe and
yeah
story, honestly.
Yeah,
like they set up everything so and these characters so well that you could just go off of that.
Yeah, it's really interesting. So,
yeah, that would say about that.
This was something that I noticed that I like as I was compiling this, the topics for this week. I was like, oh, this one's cool, but I was like, we're good here. We don't really need any more. Let me just check one more thing, and then I saw this that I remembered hearing about in the past week. Spoilers for League of Legends, I guess. Riot Games killed off a champion.
Is this like in their lore or something?
Yeah,
or
are they were apparently doing an event, like that changed the way things looks. Like Ryan, the manager, was telling me that the gosh dang, that Aram, the Howling Abyss, isn't even the Howling Abyss anymore. It's like a different thing. So they killed off Gangplank in the lore somehow. I don't fully get how it's working, but they killed off Gangplank. Misfortune killed him. And I'm trying to open my League of Legends right now, and I can't. Basically, the what's funny here, look at this picture, people. There, you logged in, and there's like, you know, a little notification like when something's happening, like with tech stuff. But it just says, Gangplank is dead and has been disabled in all queues.
Rip.
So it's like, all right, that's kind of cool. But apparently, I'm reading the last paragraph, and this is basically what I was just going to say, and I skimmed that, and I was like, oh, well, this is what the guy is saying. He said, so yeah, my guess is that there will be some comic book-style resurrection. It's like, yeah, probably. But then, pretty much, they confirmed it. There's, like, another article that was like, oh, wait, he's not totally dead. He's coming back as, like, maybe this is an excuse to do a rework, you know what I mean? Like, they... Freaking, he's coming back and he's missing an arm.
You know, yeah.
And he has like a whole new character model.
What I'm thinking is that maybe they're doing this as like a champion rotation. Bring new champions in, put the old out. I don't know.
It brings attention to things. It makes things interesting. Like, we were playing, you know, freaking imagine, like, I played League of Legends for like a year. Imagine if during that time, it wasn't just League of Legends, and it was like, this person died. Like, whoa, what's going on here?
What if you had really all the champions, and like every time you lost a match with that champion, they just died and you couldn't use them anymore?
That permadeath League of Legends. That'd be messed up, mate.
I mean, of course, it would like be like reset. It would be reset like over a period of time. But
be interesting.
That would be interesting content.
Yeah, that's a cool concept. But yeah, I don't know. I saw that and I was like, that's really cool. So yeah.
Yeah.
Another thing about developers being really cool, on a kind of sadder note, I read this article about, I found this, I don't know where I found this. I found this on GameSpot, I think. This one guy was apparently playing The Last of Us with his dad, and they were like taking turns playing, and his dad's like health started to decline when they were playing, and so his dad passed away, and the guy wrote a letter to Naughty Dog saying how much the game meant to them and stuff like that, and Naughty Dog sent him like a care package of like a collector's edition of the game and the soundtrack and like a personal letter that was like, this is why we make games, we really appreciate you writing the letter, we can't imagine how you feel, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it's so sad. But it's like, that's such an awesome thing for Naughty Dog to do. He said, when I read that you felt you were with your father again while playing it, it nearly drove me to tears. Like, and then they just went on and say, this is why we make games, and we're really glad you enjoyed it, and stuff like that. And you got to have those memories with your dad.
Yeah. So, that's like a great... like game to play because it's so emotional.
Naughty Dog is again just awesome. Naughty Dog's such a great dev studio.
Yeah.
And not just like the games, like the people there are really cool. Like Bruce Straley, Neil Druckmann, all those guys are really awesome. So
I mean Neil's cool, but he hangs out with Miss Sarkeesian.
Greg used to associate himself with her. I think everyone used to, and now I haven't seen so much.
Yeah.
I haven't seen so much from anyone. So I think they all are sort of like...
killer kind of in separate ways.
Right. After they realized... I had, all this time, I had like something on my Battlefront disc. On the front, not the back, where like it reads.
Your Battlefront disc?
Yeah, I had like a little...
Oh, disc. I thought you said desk. I was like, huh?
I have a whole custom Battlefront disc.
Yeah.
It's like a hologram. It's like a glass desk, but instead of like fish inside, it's like just a holograph of like the freaking Battle of Hoth. That'd be dope.
What if it was like an overtop view? The whole desk was like an overtop view and very detailed version of Sea Battle of Hoth.
And like you could do Iron Man style like commands where you're like boop boop boop. Oh, that'd be awesome.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
So something that I thought you would find funny, and then we can talk about whatever the crap you want to talk about, Eric. But I thought this was hilarious. Let me find the quote. Oh, okay. So, Guacamelee developer Drinkbox. Those are the guys who made Guacamelee. Freaking love Guacamelee. They're working on a Vita-exclusive game called Severed, which I actually don't know much about, but I know that it was, like, one that basically, I really need to be looking about, like, watching. And because it apparently has, like, some really cool concepts, and it's freaking people made Guacamelee. So this is the paragraph on GameSpot. It says, Severed's been delayed. It was previously expected to launch this summer, but Drinkbox needs a few additional months of playtesting and tuning to ensure it's the best it can be. And then this is the best freaking part of this that I think you'll find hilarious. We also need sufficient time to add more memes and dumb jokes.
What the heck?
Yep. That was an official quote from Drinkbox. So, yeah.
Great.
I'm telling you, man. Guacamelee is awesome.
They should have said, like, dank memes.
There's a whole hidden area where there's just a QR code on the wall. And you scan it with your phone. And it's like, and the message is, congratulations, you know how to scan a QR code. And then it's just in Guacamelee. So yeah,
it'd be funny if someone like struggled so much to get the QR scanner on their phone, and it just turned out to be that. But they did learn how to.
It's like, oh, I did it! Secret sense of accomplishment that game.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know much about Severed, but I bet it's gonna be real good. I'm excited for that.
I still have Guacamelee like right here. Guacamelee, like, I'm looking at it. I haven't touched it though.
It's great.
It's right there.
At least add it to your backlog and what you want to eventually play, because I like it a lot.
Yeah.
So what do you want to talk about?
First thing there.
La la la. You're like singing there. So.
This is good news. I like this news right here.
Yeah. We're blowing through most of this news, because I think we want to actually end on time. We always go either 10 minutes over,
and then or 30 or 45 minutes. Like,
yeah, or very rarely, but it's happened. Like, we've done, like, 50 minutes, but we very rarely just hit an hour, and that's what I want to do. So, Silent Hills, Kojima, and Del Toro, they are apparently both still planning on working together at some point.
And apparently, they said something about it's not going to be a video game, but Kojima wants to try to get into maybe filmmaking with Del Toro. So
yeah,
I'm down, because Del Toro is awesome. Kojima has done great work, so
yeah.
I'm sure Kojima could do well with like environments and stuff like that. I don't know.
This article on IGN says, Del Toro, in an interview with IGN, Del Toro said, "I love working with Kojima. We're still in touch. We're still friends and working into doing something together. But that's not going to be Silent Hills." So, yeah, I'm glad that it's not like, I don't know, Silent Hills. I feel like, I don't know what's going on over at Konami, but I feel like it has some sort of bad blood, and they just don't want to.
Yeah. The main reason that Silent Hills, like, every time I think about it, it just hurts, because after you finish the PT demo, you see Del Toro, Kojima, Norman Reedus, and it's like, oh my gosh, these three names are great. And then it's just, it's gone. It's gone.
Yeah. Dang, son.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Rise of the Tomb Raider exclusivity. The devs came. This happened last week. We talked about this last week, where we're like, they officially announced when it was coming to other platforms. But the devs came out and were like, it wasn't an easy decision to make, but we had to do it. So,
look at the top comment on IGN article.
Let's see. Oh, I don't know how to sort by best.
Oh my god.
I hope fans know that it wasn't an easy decision, said Rogers, as he's wiping his tears with money. Let's see. Let's find a good quote here. Having been working with us on previous games in a lesser sense, they've been supportive. However, for Rise of Tomb Raider, they've just brought this passion and belief that has really enabled us to blow people away. People should feel that about Microsoft. Their commitment to Tomb Raider is just amazing for us. So, I think Microsoft just really just went for the balls on this deal.
Yeah,
they're like, we really, gotta get this.
They really, I think they want more than, they like looked over at PlayStation and like, wow, they have Uncharted, they have Infamous, they have all these other games, and we have like Halo and
yeah.
Gears of War.
But
I mean, they're not like bad games, I'm just saying
Phil Spencer is doing a mighty fine job over there. That's all I gotta say. Like, what's great is, like, you for real need to listen to, I think it's Unlocked 201. You need to listen to the podcast where he's talking with three people who were in charge of Xbox at some point. There was one that had to deal with the Red Ring of Death. There's Phil Spencer, who's in charge now. And there was one who had to deal with the launch of the original Xbox. And they were all, like, in an interview in the podcast. It was amazing. And freaking Phil Spencer, like, they really addressed how, like, he took over after that one E3 where it was messed up. He came in after that, and that's where it was like, all right, we realize and we're changing. And he's like, and it's basically all, not all him, but like the direction of like, all right, we gotta change this. We can't do this. That's mostly Phil Spencer like pushing everyone for that, which is awesome.
Also, speaking of Xbox, does Xbox One got that new OS yet?
No. I don't know when that's coming. I think that's coming this fall, supposedly. I think it was supposedly this fall, but yeah, I think it is.
Came out with Windows 10.
Yeah. It's supposed to like work really well with Windows 10 and stuff, so that's cool. But yeah, that and backwards compatibility and Halo 5.
That is crazy. You can play Halo Reach.
Yeah, dude. Xbox One's looking dope this holiday. They oh gosh. This holiday season they're gonna win some months over PS4. November, maybe they're gonna win.
Oh yeah.
October, stuff like that.
Would you assume that they would probably like stuff that's gonna be backwards compatible, it's gonna be like digital or
oh gosh, I'm dying. They apparently worked it out. The system is that it's both. As in, like, if you bought an Xbox Arcade game on your Xbox One, it will just be available to download. And
does that mean that I can get my games? A lot of arcade games on my Xbox 360.
If it's compatible with the backwards compatibility program, yes. Which is an actual program, though. That's what's weird. Like, they're rolling out 100 games at launch, and that's it. But then they're gonna start adding them. But if they're compatible, it will just be available to download on Xbox One, which is awesome.
I have a like obscene amount of games on that 200 gigabyte hard drive.
Yeah, and also, it like say if you bought Gears of War 1 digitally, it's there and you can download it. If you have it on a disc, you should be able to just insert the disc. So. Yeah. That supposedly it works both ways, which is awesome.
I want to just throw something out there for a second. On the Xbox One and PS4, it comes standard usually with 500 gigabytes. That goes by pretty fast on these consoles. But here's something funny I've noticed. I just remembered. On my Xbox 360, I had like below 100 gigabytes. And I was fine for until I was like 16 or something. Games and then I got a 250 gigabyte. And that was like so much space to me on the Xbox 360 because games weren't that big.
Yeah, dude.
I just thought that was weird.
Now you got GTA that's like 60 freaking gigs itself.
Battlefield 4 was like one of the first games that came on PS4 and it was like 50.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I don't.
It's crazy.
It's crazy. One more quick thing about Fallout 4 that I want to toss out there. The game was basically done before Bethesda even announced it, is what they said. Like, before they announced it, they're just working on bugs, just polishing stuff.
That's good, because
which is how developers should do it from now on.
Honestly, because
so great,
especially in a Bethesda game, there is an obscene amount of bugs. They should right now. They've shown enough that they could probably send it out to select people who are trusted. They can put an NDA or whatever that word is. But they could use them, those people, to see for bug testing and maybe get. They probably have enough money from like T-shirts and novelty items to hire a bunch of just beta t-shirts. Testers right now. You know, they'll get it sorted out.
It said, the quote is, let's be honest, it doesn't matter what anybody wants for a feature in Fallout 4. The game is basically done. It was by and large done before we announced it in terms of the features going in. Not adding new features in May, June, July in the year you're releasing. You're trying to get everything fixed. So that's pretty much all they're doing, which is awesome. So just a quick little bit. Fallout 4, one of the crazy, awesome games coming out. Another quick thing, and then the Destiny Weekly update, and then the drop, and then we'll go. PS4 sales numbers have officially reached 25.3 million units.
That's crazy. Over what? The Xbox what?
I don't know. Let me see.
I'm going to guess like 5 million.
No. I'm going to. Yeah, my guess was 10 million.
Yeah, I was thinking. Yeah, I remember the Vita and the Xbox One had like 10 million or something. They both like 10 million.
Yeah, the I'm reading this article to see if I can find some big numbers.
Wait, 253?
No, what? No.
On the link itself, it says 253 million units worldwide.
Oh, okay, because you can't, you know, put a .3.
Yeah, that was like
253 is not. The PS3 only sold 80 million. Well, let's see here. The PS4 still has a lot to work to do to catch up to its predecessor, as the PlayStation 3 has sold more than 80 million units worldwide as of November 2013. Freaking crap. As of November 2013, the console had been out for like 4 or 5 years, and it had 80. We're getting close to halfway of 80 in, like, what, 2 years?
Yeah.
It's gonna get. It's gonna at least get to that.
I feel like point. Once we start seeing more, I don't know. When we start seeing more like big exclusive and, big exclusives for PS4, we're gonna see like more sales.
But see, that's the thing. I don't think. It's crazy that it's sold that the PS4 has sold this well. Just on like third party support and freaking like there's been a good amount of first party exclusives, but not a ton of Uncharted 4s, you know? Not a ton of big temple stuff like that. There's been a couple, but not as much as usual, I guess you could say. I don't know.
Right.
But yeah, not like every fall there's one giant one, stuff like that. Like this fall there's not much. When it comes to first-party exclusives. But they're still doing that well. But that's why I think Xbox is going to pull ahead this fall. Not pull ahead, but catch up a tiny bit.
Yeah, especially with Halo, I would say.
Especially with Halo and backwards compatibility and the new UI. Like, backwards compatibility is one of the reasons why I was like, okay, I should definitely get this Xbox.
Right.
So, Eric, what was your favorite thing about the Bungie Weekly update this week?
Let me think. Probably the update itself, the whole update.
It's a horrible answer.
Entire article.
What was your favorite thing? All of it.
Okay. No, Dark Void.
Oh, really? That's okay. That's cool. I like his. I like that his weapon is not.
I'm just something new. It's something new.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting. A new enemy, like. Like, I don't think people realize this. We haven't fought a new enemy for, like, months, you know? Like...
Not one that has a really cool-looking axe.
Yeah, that's what it's all about, this really cool-looking axe right here. Frick. But that's what I was saying. Like, it's not, like, a generic regular sword. Like, it's an axe. It's like a freaking...
Awesome.
Look at this crap here. I'll put it on the main screen. Look at that. That's cool. This is Darkblade. This is Weapon. This is him with, like, he's got freaking...
Yeah, also the fact that the Dreadnought is not just the raid area. It's a freaking patrol area.
Yeah.
An exploration area. And it's... There's gonna be more, like, bosses, apparently.
What it seems like is that there might be world bosses. Like, there might be zone bosses.
Like, you just go into a room, like, boom.
Like, you're playing Wildstar, and one of the quests is wanted. You need a group to beat this boss that's hanging out in this area.
Yeah.
Maybe that's how it... Like, imagine that was a thing in Cosmodrome. It kind of is with the wolves.
Yeah.
Well, it kind of is with the wolves, but... That's more of a horde, but in this case, it's going to be a boss that has, like, how I imagine it, at least, is a boss with a unique mechanic.
Yeah, and this is, and they like, even said, this isn't going to be easy mode patrol anymore.
Yeah, because
I, be like,
I like the wolves. I like that a group, like, legitimately, like, it's hard to do it yourself. It's possible, but it's hard to do it yourself. You have to, like... With other, like, when other people start joining, it really helps. So, like, it brings people together in an area. It's kind of like public events were meant to do. But, like, that, with a unique boss, that's really cool.
Yeah, man.
And there's also gonna be a new raid. Just tossing that out there. They didn't talk about that at all, but...
There's just one thing that's kind of, like... I don't know, I'm really a little... I'm sure it'll be cleared up, but, like, the first picture you see on this, this update... You have four guardians just flying, casually flying to their mothership.
Yeah, I like...
You're not getting shot at or anything?
That's a good point. But I like that, I like the second paragraph. It says, perhaps daring would be more appropriate than inviting. The spacefaring fortress of destruction is far from hospitable. The Taken King himself is, after all, invading our solar system to avenge the death of his brood. You're not invited. You'll have to crash the party. Which I think is a cool concept for a story, but, like, you know, I hope it actually makes sense and is presented well.
But, and also, in that first picture, you see Saturn behind it.
Yeah, dude. You're like, oh, I'm getting a phone call. Getting a phone call. BRB.
RIP. Yeah.
And resuming. So what were you saying before I got a phone call?
Saturn.
Yeah, Saturn. Let's see
here. And here's also, I was thinking while you were, away for a minute. During the raid, what if, like, we get freaking teleported around on, like, different asteroids in freaking Saturn's ring in the Oryx fight? That would be awesome. Like, he kind of just moves you over, or you have to jump from one to one.
That would be cool. That would be definitely be cool. I'd be down for that. I'm so excited for the raid, dude. I am so... excited.
Yeah, apparently it's gonna be the biggest one too,
so. Raids are the best freaking part about Destiny. Like, I don't think people can argue that they aren't. I mean, I guess it's they true. Can preference, but, like, Vault of Glass and even Crota's End are both like the top two things to do in Destiny, like, when it comes to just pure fun. Like, they're really, really cool.
Yeah,
and this is supposed to be, like, the biggest, most ambitious raid they've done. It's supposed to have, like, four parts instead of, like, three, and I don't know. I'm very excited. Very. Very. Excited. All right. So that's most of the weekly update. Let's see. Here's all the cool creations. I'll go over these real quick. Look at that. Oh, so pretty. Oh, so cool. Look, it's a shank cake, basically. They also talked about how they were sending out another wave of bans for people cheating.
Yeah.
Them there are cheaters.
Yeah, the problem is that some of these cheaters aren't actually cheaters. I've been hearing about this for a while. Like, people with bad connection have been getting, like, bad, or have been getting banned, weekly. Apparently, I heard this from Gathalion, by the way, and he was, like, tweeting about it and made a video on it. And one of his friends on, who regularly streams on Twitch, got banned.
Yeah, that's a bummer.
From Crucible for, like, a week. And obviously he wasn't, like, connection manipulating. Someone was just having a bad connection, and the system pinged him and banned him.
That's weird. You would think they would do more investigating into who gets banned, but...
Right. Like, people can't play a certain game mode for a whole week. That's pretty big, honestly.
Some people get account banned and console banned.
Yeah.
Like, but yeah, so hopefully, I don't know, look into that more, Bungie.
Yeah.
Hire us!
Honestly, get...
I'll sit there at a computer and watch videos
sure
all day.
You could get some people to this... I don't know, you should probably pay them pretty well so they know what they're doing, but...
But realistically, I know it's not...
Realistically.
I'm saying realistically, I know it's not a very easy thing to do, but hopefully they get their poop together.
Yeah.
But it's not easy. They can't, you know...
Automated systems are tricky.
Yeah. And you know, we say it's as easy as just hiring people, but, you know, sometimes they can't freaking hire people. Sometimes they don't have another slot. Sometimes they can't create a job with that, but... I don't know. Hopefully they get that together because that ain't cool.
With Activision.
Yeah. The new EA summer con. No, I'm just kidding. The drop was again the simplified version. And you want to know something interesting about the drop this week? There's like nothing on it.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's a very small drop. I think this is the smallest drop we've done.
What is going on, Ryan Clements? You need to charge the powerhouse.
Wow, that's not how that works. He is the PlayStation powerhouse. He has to charge himself.
Yes.
Plug yourself into a wall socket. Don't do that. It's not safe.
Do not go get a fork and put it into the outlet in your wall.
Don't forget to put water on the fork.
Yes.
Do not
bring the toaster with you in the bathroom. You'll probably die.
Dang. So yeah, I'll just go over these real quick because there's like five of them.
And there's nothing to say about them.
Yep.
There's
nothing to say. So I'm just
going
to
read
them
off. You don't know what they are. There's nothing to tell us about what they are besides maybe Galaxy.
Yeah, that's the only... There's screenshots. So yeah, I'll just read them all and then you can talk about the screenshots. Eterno Blade, PS4 Digital. Boggle, PS4 Digital. The Castle Game, PS4 Digital. What a great title. Galaxy the Dimensional, PS4 Digital, Submerged, PS4 Digital, Transgalactic Tournament, PS4 Digital. I feel like there's a space theme going on here.
Yeah.
So yeah, look at these.
So the screenshots, explosions,
cool art style.
Looking
cool.
It
kind of looks like a velocity type thing.
Yeah. But it looks like also kind of like an arcade-y type thing. So yeah,
might want to look into that maybe possibly. It's part of the it's part of the summer sale, the like where they like promote a game each week that comes out. It's that one. So.
Huh.
I don't know.
All right. Well, I mean, if you care, we got Luke Bryan Kill the Lights coming to PlayStation.
I don't even know what that is. I don't even understand.
It's a song
but
Luke
no, I
Bryan.
Mean like PlayStation Music. I thought they got rid of that when they partnered with Spotify, but apparently they never did.
No, they didn't. And Fear Factory by Gen Nexus?
So yeah.
Batman Unlimited Monster Mayhem. That's what's coming to PlayStation Video.
It's the most useless information we give out.
Batman Unlimited. At least it's Batman. That's something we know. So.
That's a good point. For real, we read that off every week, and I don't think anyone pays any attention to this.
Yeah, honestly, what is going on, Ryan?
Dang, son. First name basis, I see. But
Mr. Clements.
But yeah, I don't know. It's interesting, but. It was, just, you know, take this time. You don't have to play those games. Maybe you can if you're interested, but you don't have to. Take this time, finish your backlog, get ready for the Taken King, get ready for the fall, because your life is about to go away. You're not going to have a social life once those games hit. So just say goodbye to your loved ones. Use this week to just say goodbye to everybody. Finish Mass Effect. Maybe start
also,
Mass Effect
you have to
if
take
you're
away
like me.
Some, Take away some time from work so you can... Actually, no, you'll be at school.
I'll be at school. I'll have to freaking do classes and exams. It's gonna suck.
Where did you pre-order... Where do you pre-order games? Do you just...
Digitally. That's the point. Like, that's why I did it digitally.
I totally forgot.
That's why I started doing that. Some of them I don't want to... I think Battlefront I want to get physically because I got the Battlefront 2 disc over there. Or actually right here because I freaking picked it up. But most of them, you know, it's fine. It's fine.
Yeah.
Peter, it's not in your pants. Are you happy to see me? Oh, sorry. Okay. That's a horrible impression. So, finish Mass Effect out there. People will do your bounties, play Trials, do Skolas, get the Elder Ciphers, and...
Yep.
Eric, we should both show our random thing, and you know what it should be? Is both of our Battlefront discs.
Yes.
Here, show and tell. We do this every week, in case you're new to the podcast. We just show off a random thing at the end of the show. Look at it. It's beautiful.
And we have two different consoles.
Yeah, mine's PS2. By the way, yours says Xbox at the top. PlayStation 2 is at the bottom for me.
Down here. Yeah. It says Xbox Live. That's what it used to say on like all the boxes. It's just like this weird line.
That's very odd. That's cool, though.
The back is like very scratched.
Yeah, too. I bet mine is, too. Let me look.
Like, I wouldn't even try the...
Mine still worked. Back, like, you know, I don't think it would... I don't think it got this scratched before I put it into hiding for years. But Battlefront? By the way, Eric, we didn't reach our time. We're about 10 minutes over. Like usual. Go pop in this disc to your PlayStation 2 or your original Xbox and play it. That's your homework for this week, kids.
Yep.
And we'll see you next week. Bye. I'm gonna go eat a salad.